Why do you ask this?
Because it depends on where you're gonna go.
Not really. Or you still can't always
in this case.
In this case, you already know the terms.
Seven or something like that, or five, because it's working too much. No, I'm not doing fine, so we're having 2 minutes, for example.
In 2 minutes?
In 2 minutes. this ist eine Konzert. Ein komisches Konzert.
So, welcome everyone. This is social dissonance. Sorry, excuse me. This information is important. So, this is social dissonance. It is a durational concert. I have to inform you that we are being filmed and the video is being streamed online on Periscope. And tomorrow it's going to be shown in this screen and archived on YouTube and archive.org. Also, I would like to inform you that the concert will take place for 1 hour, and it is better for you and for us if you stay for the whole duration. So if you think that you cannot stay for 1 hour, maybe it is better to go now.
Say the feedback to me.
So, there's another thing.
Hey!
If you decide to leave at some point during the concert, you will be asked to give us some feedback in order for us to learn from you and improve.
So, you will be able only to leave from that door. And if you stay, please commit that you will be, if you want to leave, you will give some feedback so we can learn from you. So this, I hope this is understood, and then you follow. Are you artist? Eh? No? This will last for an hour. Mm-hmm. Would you like to commit for it or? No? Okay, so it's better that you leave now.
Yeah, more or less.
Okay. So you stay at the front of the room.
The next separation is going to be between people who use Facebook and people who don't use Facebook. Next separation is going to be between people who use Facebook and people who don't use Facebook. So people who use Facebook should come over here, and people who don't use Facebook should go over there. Thank you. or something?
On a scale of depending on how people feel, below 50% happiness, above 50% happiness. So people who are above this line are supposed to be 50% or above happy. So would you, where do you think you are?
Okay, I make up my mind.
Okay. Are you above 50? Just to let you know that when there is people that they take the distance, it becomes very, very awkward for the people that don't take the distance to. So just to let you know that you're making it more awkward, but okay. Why are we more or less happy, or at least, you know, we can describe that we are 50% more happy. So if we can come up with a list of reasons, that would be great. Can people remember? Okay. Confidence?
I know what I want.
Relax.
Okay. Maybe the best thing is to write them down. Okay. So let's go all together in the computer. Then we will share it.
I
think it's
fine.
We don't forget, because there is also already very clear suggestions. Okay. So the first one was?
Well, I know who I am.
Sunshine was the first one.
Sunshine.
Okay. So if you could push that, just like the ones that you say, it's better that you type it, so it's. It's already, you can type.
Food.
But anyway, I think, I don't know how to scale myself on the scale of 0 to 100 and happiness, because that's not what I relate my life to. So in that sense, I think happiness is a construction. So especially relating to this text here. So that's why.
What does that word, happiness, where does it originate?
Yeah, that's the question I was thinking about, because I didn't know how to actually deal with this task, because nobody actually gave a definition of happiness. And then for myself, I decided that, okay, at the beginning I felt more positive, just because I'm here and, you know, I'm very excited. It's my first time at Documento, so lots of happiness, like lots of positive thoughts, but then I got a little bit irritated.
What do you think?
something extraordinary has to happen. Don't you understand this? Something big. You know why? No? Because violence is more interesting than murder.
For them too.
Yes. And maybe you're getting more than what I'm getting, because you were sitting on that side. So you could have been more happy.
Sunshine, I know what I want. Confidence. Food. Because I know myself. Shared experience. Good health. I feel blessed. A good night's sleep and coffee. I love my daughter. Poetry. I'm alive. Are we getting a rating for the pitch? Oh, we are getting a rating. Thank you.
birthday. And I feel the moment. Do you agree? Do you feel the moment?
Yes.
Something amazing happened to me today. Let's guess what? I have free time. I guess we all enjoy that. Yay!
Happy people. Could we share now the comments or the list from the less happy people? The less happy people there.
What?
The people who were talking in regards to the less, why, the reasons why.
You are not happy.
You are not happy.
So I just walk around the space and I just felt that place where I felt alright.
It was not
fun. For me it wasn't an absolute, I'm 60% or 70%. I just walk around the space and I felt that that side wasn't that happy after all.
Yeah.
That there were people there just because they didn't want to admit to belong over there. So I just felt better on this side. It was a feeling for me.
Well, some people
had
an unhappy perspective, but a lot just accidentally happened to be there at that moment in time. Some people had a perspective on unhappiness, but some just happened to be there accidentally at that moment in time.
Okay, so you didn't have that kind of...
We didn't have a personal...
Some reason that... Okay.
Are there any people that they have some reasons to be unhappy and they want to share with the same group in Athens?
Just happiness doesn't exist. Why do we have to have reasons to be unhappy?
I have so many reasons to be unhappy.
Yeah, but like it's...
How many words do you have happy in Greek? How many words
importance of it, because in German there's not just happy, right? Happy is very flat. It's not something I would use to describe myself. It is a very...
It's
you said Disney.
Yeah,
is a Disney
that's what
scene.
I'm saying. It's different sentiments. It's different... Different...
Yeah, but then we do have happy one person, at least you believe in being unhappy.
I do.
No, I'm asking you. Because you
I
had so many reasons to
many.
Be unhappy.
Yes, I do have many reasons.
Well, I feel it's a totally relative thing.
Relative term.
So sometimes I feel unhappy, sometimes happy. Mm-hmm. I don't relate really to happiness.
But that's funny, I cannot say I'm happy, but I can say I have so many reasons to be unhappy.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh, I can use only the opposite.
Mm-hmm. But if you state them, there are reasons that could potentially, you can find something out of them that could not be just strictly unhappiness, right?
I mean, war makes me unhappy.
Yeah, but doesn't this sound superficial in your ears?
What is superficial? I mean, like...
It's just work. Everyone has to work. Like, everyone is unhappy.
War.
Ah, okay, good. And thank you.
Work is the best thing I should do.
Yes, everyone's... Yes, we don't really... Do we know what to say to Athens? Or do they want to share?
There was a question from us.
If you wanted to share why we were unhappy.
Oh, okay.
I mean, I've got a list from the... That just says
I
the
just
same things like we just said now. I don't know. Do we want to share that?
Through the screen? I think I would rather to share it with the people who are here. The screen is kind of complicated.
Why are we focusing on the unhappy group?
Yeah.
Because the happy group has already communicated to Athens why they were happy.
But not to us? To the unhappy group?
Yes.
Oh yeah, they could have heard it, I think.
Just preparing it,
just
actually. I think.
Yeah, we weren't that interested.
No, I think we started with the reasons for being happy, and then we wrote it down and read it out to the other group, basically. And then, so that's what I got. They came back telling us what is the reason for them being happy. So now we're doing the same, just in unhappy, actually. So this is the second part. So now everybody's saying, or might or can say, why they are not happy. Uh-huh. And then I think we might go and tell the other group in Athens.
Okay, I'm sorry, I didn't pay attention.
I mean, that's how I actually got it.
Makes sense.
Maybe we should listen to the people if you want to say something, or anyone wants to tell the reasons why they are happy. We should just listen to them. That we did before.
But sometimes it's difficult to say why you are unhappy, but maybe it's easier to say what would make you happy. So what had to change for you to be happy? Maybe that's easier.
Yeah, but that's one of the mysteries of life. I mean, seriously, what's going to make me happy?
But sometimes it's difficult for people to speak out what makes them unhappy, because it's just that makes
because
them
it's a temporary, it's a permanent state. For me, unhappiness is something that is more temporary. Yeah, I was saying that before to my group.
Okay.
Like I feel like it is something that I have to choose not to be completely sunken by it. I have to get up and, I don't know, drink a glass of water and just put the little
whiskey
ginger that I want to drink so I can feel my throat being a little more happy. But with the moment that we wake up, it's an effort to be happy from when you wake up, because it's war. There's shit all over. So it's a choice to be happy for little small things that you do. Because you read it, you see unhappiness everywhere around you. Everywhere you look. So it's a matter of just from this like massive unhappiness, blackness, racist, fucked up world that we live in.
It's
terrible. It's everything. We just need to like focus on really small steps with everything. But
not about you. It's not about you. It's not about you. It's not about you. Not about you. It's not about you.
I don't understand a word because of the acoustics in here, and so it gets so mushed up,
and why
and it makes me unhappy.
And why you're unhappy?
Why are you unhappy? Because I don't understand a word. I can't follow what the others say, especially if more than one person speaks.
But I think that's healthy and it helps the situation to emerge. Yeah, I think it's exciting. I really like it. It's the best thing I've seen yet. Yes.
What do you think?
I think that I don't quite understand the kind of rules and constructs of what's happening, and so I'm observing from a distance.
Okay. But on the matter of being happy or unhappy, what?
Well, just the whole interaction of things, you know, that there occasionally is this kind of vocalized sound coming from the back to kind of redirect attention, and so there seems to be kind of an overlaying concept that is being directed, but I feel like it's not necessarily being articulated to all the participants, and so thus I'm kind of just watching and seeing what happens.
Do you notice that the most confident people, they tend to be the center of attention?
Yeah.
Hello. What do you think?
Right now?
Yeah.
Like, asking myself where this is going to go.
There are some people that want to give some feedback.
Are you with you?
Yes.
Would you like to give us some feedback so we improve?
So you improve? Actually, we're just leaving because...
It's a bit all over the place. Social distance, it's a bit too easy. It ends up in like people talking next to each other. This is a normal evening at the bar.
And the transmission of information is not very clear. I don't know what these people are talking about, even if I'm close and it's here all over the place. So.
It's just like this is a regular day in life. I mean, I don't need to be with this like this too.
And they just told us that this looks like a normal day in the bar.
In the bar?
Yeah.
We said that we don't need to be here to receive this information, okay? We could also talk about
this ends up in semantics, and there's no clear, like, at the beginning it started as a bit of a TV show where they give you these binary systems, blah, 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 and then you start, where is it going? And then now it's just like an evening at the bar with friends talking about stuff in your life, so. I mean, it was nice meeting everyone. It started as a TV show, and now it's more like an evening at the bar, and it was nice meeting you all, but I want to see other stuff also.
Unfortunately,
you pay for the drinks, right?
What? No.
Can I just ask you something? Because it's really nice criticism or
perspective, but it's so sad that you leave and why just say it and leave. Because maybe then...
we're not contributing to this at all. So
we're now we're contributing and now you can talk about it when we're gone.
But why do you want to stay and contribute a bit more now that you've kind of given up?
Because then it's still an evening. This is our contribution and you can do with it what you want. This is our part to your conversation. Have a nice evening.
Two different things, feeling happy in yourself and feeling the weight of the world. I don't think they're the same things. So on the unhappy side, there's a lot of conversation about the fact that there's war and displacement and a lot to be unhappy about in the world. But I think it's setting up a false binary with the people who said they were happy.
I'm thinking about how I'll get some food and how I'll make it to the next event, a documenta, trying to feel kind of and feeling increasingly unhappy as I'm trying to work out the logistics in my mind, how to make it after this performance to the next thing and the next thing. So, but I guess that's kind of the kind of condition in the, a luxury condition for people that have too much time and too much money.
I think today we had these separations that they worked somehow. People got angry after a while. Someone threw and broke something, thinking that he was saying something about the people that they don't react maybe. And then it became a kind of personal situation that people started exchanging their personal opinions about life. More confident people seemed to be able to discuss between them what was going on. Less confident people remained outside of the circle and didn't share so much and didn't spoke about what they were thinking. And that's it. Less happy people also, I think, they contributed much less to this discussion. Like,
no, the other way around. We were the ones who were happy. No, we were laughing more in the happy group than we were talking more.
We analyzed why
we were having fun.
Happy people were silent.
Yeah.
It's just only
both happy people and unhappy people don't care about unconfident people.
Oh, no, but why are you labeling them unconfident? Maybe there could be many reasons.
Less confident.
Why not?
Because I noticed that three, four people became the center of attention. They tried to take all the lives.
But there's no rule. There is nothing you can say for everybody.
I know.
Yeah.
It's not for everybody. It's like for five people that they kept all their information.
I know, but I just wanted.
So it was very interesting the fact that when the two groups formed, the happy and the unhappy one, there were some people that started going back and forth, and I think the majority of them were from the happy group. It was as if the happy people were more able to change position than the unhappy ones. The unhappy ones seemed to be much more static in their own place. I found very interesting the move with the violent move of someone that wanted to break the situation. But it didn't seem to shake people so much. I think maybe what he was trying to, his point maybe was that we are following this core, and this core involves questioning how instrumentalized we become in our everyday lives. So in a way it was much easier to stay in the situation we were already, which was quite normal. We could speak about things we speak in our everyday life and maintain this dialectic situation than to actually reflect on what is happening inside the space. Yeah. And at the same time, there were some people that chose to take the role of the spectator. About the contributions thing, about the mostly happy people trying to prove how much they contributed to the piece, I'm not sure if contribution means that you speak most or that you are more active. You can contribute with your position inside the space in any way.
But is the hour over with this analysis, this overall view?
What? What did you say?
Is the hour over? I was just asking, because it seems like it's kind of
closing.
Yeah?
Is the work done?
Have you used this enough?
I'm very uncomfortable with these summaries, you know, like, we are here 40 minutes and people are expressing feelings and then we reach these conclusions. I'm happy people contributing ways and this and that. Why have these summaries and these conclusions? I mean, this is not a scientific study, right? I mean, this is a place something should be happening here. And every time something seems to be happening, somebody has a conclusion.
I think it is a scientific study. That's why I don't think it's artwork in the conventional form. I think that remark completely threw me off, actually. Like, I think that it is a space where this interaction is being analyzed. It's not a bar, as the guy said. It's much more complicated than that. And that's what we are being studied here constantly. That's why it's really uncomfortable, because you develop certain exchanges with people that we say things about really human true existential nature, and then you've been put in bullet points. Oh yeah, he threw the score. Who even is following the score? Nothing. They're just telling us what to talk about, and we're biting the thread, how do you say this? We're biting the food, the beet, and then we're like following this direction. But because we're humans, me personally, because I care about these things and I think about them every single day, I'm opening up. But they forcibly close us back. So they want us to go to the world and not even talk to anyone again, keep on going. So that's why it's a pretty complicated situation that they put us in, which is not an artwork. It's an exercise, an investigation. It's like an experiment. We are in an experiment.
But I think due to the fact that it is about something, like there's aboutness in it.
Everything is about something. You go and drink water, it's about something.
That's why I said
it is.
And
everything is
about it. You seem to be very confident. I propose in these last 3 minutes that we try to do a material analysis of her confidence.
I know.
Where do you think this confidence comes from?
Why analyze her confidence?
Yeah. We're just trying. I mean, here we're trying to unravel how people present themselves, and especially confidence people, how, you know, what kind of
why single out as an individual?
Yeah.
I mean, as far as the little text that we got, you know, the collective subject, why single out the individual? And you were all singing, the three of you, it's not about you, it's not about you.
I'm staring at myself. I'm making myself vulnerable. I'm not taking any power here. I'm opening up because it's my opportunity to talk to people that I'll never see again. It doesn't mean I'm overpowering them. And you are the evil force, but because I'm...
I feel very protective about her, you know, leave her alone. I don't know her, but, it's not a way to do things. Because you are in the position of the power here, being the organizer.
Well, people take it and give it back. It's not, you know, there's no...
Why don't we analyze you?
Please go ahead.
Why don't we analyze...
Please go ahead.
Is this, point.
This is what this is about. This is the point, precisely the point.
What was it about then? If it's not about her or the people that you've invited into this room to contribute, who is it about?
It is about her, but it is about everybody and how we present ourselves. Mm-hmm. At some point, I don't know if you felt this, but we felt that maybe she was taking too much space while other people were not taking any.
Because she lightens everything up, and otherwise we just be talking about nothing, right? So it's you rely on somebody to make themselves.
And then you point them out.
Vulnerable.
This doesn't come from nothing. This comes from a confidence that has built through the years. We just want to try to...
You have no right to tell me...
Maybe it's desperation. Come on.
You have no right to put names on me.
You
don't know me and you've done it.
I've seen you in a couple of these, and you take more space than others in this 55 times that we've been doing it. So it's not out of the loop.
Now you say, oh, you know more than we do, because if you do things a lot, and maybe she's almost here.
This is also a debate.
The first one, I've only come once, and it was the second one you ever did, and it was the most awkward experience, because another person was, and I was just in the room. And you've created an image about me.
Did I create an image? My friend? Or did I create an image person?
And now your friend, the minute is coming.
Jackal!
Lack of argument.